The reason why we have a multiplier effect in the economy is because of the way households behave. And the way households behave is captured by the behavioral equation, which says that consumption spending of households equals autonomous consumption plus small c, that's the marginal propensity to consume, times the level of output and income. So according to this equation, if there's an increase in income, households will then increase their consumption spending. And this is the reason why you have a multiplier effect. If you look at your circular flow model, where you have your firms, households, and let's assume the firms pay households 100 in income, marginal propensity to consume is 0.8, and as you know, then they will increase their consumption spending with 80. As they increase their consumption spending with 80, firms will produce goods and services for these households worth 80, which then becomes income again. Which then households will spend 80% of that, which is equal to 64. And there you have the multiplier effect. Now this statement says, what if it's not true that if households increase their spending, if this relationship does not hold, and does not increase their consumption spending. So an increase in income does not lead to an increase in consumption spending. There will be no multiplier effect. And that is indeed correct, because you have a multiplier because of the way households behave according to this behavioral equation.